Rough draft.
She asked if people can hear music in heaven. 7 years old and innocent, but passionate. Passionate enough to wonder if her brother and the angel now would be afforded the opportunity to listen because she was playing for him. And although her sunny days will not, forever be dimmed, all that she's left to grip is that small lint of hope that sound waves travel upwardly through some type of telescope, because the only cure, the only antidote for this innocent heart is to let off melodies as sweet as suspended petals into the universe, hoping that even if only a couple of those petals make it to heaven, Matthew would know that this distorted harmony was meant for him. So she begins to play. Every single key, gracefully touched, as her fingerprints caress the ivory and spade colored keys. Her gracious moves were effortless, as if an angel were guiding her wrists as her fingertips tiptoed across the piano. She was only 7 years old and arguably on her way to surpass the likes of Beethoven and Mozart. Each petal, a melody composed, fertile enough to infect a flower with growth and turn sorrow into hope, hoping that one day, someday soon, she would share another room with Matthew, somewhere where they could make music, him playing the violin and she playing the piano, somewhere where there are no cars, somewhere above the stars, because an automobile is what struck him and left her arms empty, lacking an embrace, and a mentality paralyzed to the point where all she can think about is when they used to catch fireflies. Matthew held the jar, and she held the lid. And now, without warning, without a glimpse of a smile to say goodbye, she, this innocent heart, is sibling free, detached from society, journeying through piano keys, replaying, reliving their history in black and white, wondering if her suspended petals could have saved her brother's life that night from a hit and run driver that's probably hit every single key that she pressed, but he or she is too afraid to confess, so the truth remains compressed, eating away at their soul while they continue to grow old, while Matthew, an innocent bystander, caught up in the disaster of a reckless abandon, is laid to rest. So she continues to play, her voice and each key humming the same melody, trying to channel, numb, block, and nudge the pain away. But what happens when the song is over? She asks if people can hear music in heaven. So she continues to play. Thank you.